Well, according to Indeed, a search engine for job listings, there is an increase in tech workers looking for jobs outside the hubs of Silicon Valley and San Francisco. In a survey done earlier this month, Indeed found that 38% of tech job seekers located in San Francisco or San Jose are looking for looking outside those areas for jobs, I should say. That is a 41% growth since 2012. Now, the reasons for the interest outside the area include a cheaper cost of living and less competition. Mm-hmm. San Jose-based ISDI Digital University is hoping to turn things around by training and keeping tech workers here.
And they also offer the tech sector's first Master's of Internet Business degree.
We're more. We're joined by ISDI co-founder and head of digital transformation, Steve Cadigan. Steve, thank you for being with us. I was reading a little bit about you. You were at LinkedIn. You went overseas and found out that there's another program like this. It's very similar to what you're doing here. Explain how that motivated you to start it here.
Okay, well, the university that we just founded this January, and we got approval from the state of California to offer a master's degree in internet business, was really started in Spain about 9 years ago, founded in a sense of urgency in an economy where there's 30% unemployment, and businesses could not find the skills that they needed. Mm-hmm. And we're not talking about programmers or software engineers, we're talking about digital professionals, because so many companies are going through digital transformation. And I had some friends that introduced me to these folks about 3 or 4 years ago, and I was guest lecturing with them over time, and we determined that, you know, that need exists here. In fact, it even exists in Silicon Valley, which is kind of ironic when you right. think about so many technologies being based here and founded here. But the reality is that so many workers, regardless of your industry, regardless of what profession you're in, whether it's retail or banking, your jobs are changing. Right. And we haven't found any schools or institutions that are really tackling this in a holistic way.
So
that's why we found
the folks
school.
At Macy's and JCPenney's and Barnes & Noble lining up at your door, that kind of thing?
Absolutely, absolutely. Right. And I think a lot of folks, and this is the thing, we hear a lot of people asking, well, should I change my career because the internet is changing business? And the answer is not really. You don't have to. I think you need to be better at what you do, and you need to be more digitally savvy. Right. And that's what we want to do, is help people that are at Macy's, or maybe the people that used to be at Kodak, for example, or people in the car industry that are watching what Tesla's doing, for example, yeah. helping them be great at what they do.
So it's 9 months. It's a master's. It's an advanced degree. I mean, I think people have tech comfort. They don't necessarily have savvy. What are they going to get when they're finishing this course and saying, okay, now I have this degree in my hand, here's what I can do now?
Okay, well, the biggest frustration that I find, I'm a 30-year human resource executive, but the biggest frustration I find in talking to people is that the world is changing faster than our ability to keep up with it. There's always these new sexy apps or these new technologies that are changing the way people do work. And what we want to offer with our program is not only introduce people to what you need to do to be effective today in the business world, the digital business world, but to be prepared for the inevitable changes that are coming. So a lot of times I get asked, Steve, what are the most important digital business skills today? Well, I can tell you what I think they are, but the truth is, don't you want to be prepared for the business challenges and skills needed for tomorrow and the year after?
So, Steve, can students come back after they've graduated and check back in and say, hey, this is new now, can you help me out with this?
Absolutely, and that's what we're building at ISD. We're building an ecosystem where we want our alumni to come in and talk about the changes they're seeing in their organizations and really be able to help. Because today, it's impossible to know everything. So, Frank, what I would say is that our alumni network is, we want an ecosystem to help you, not only in the classroom, but well beyond, to be able to find answers.
How much does it cost, and when am I going to school? When do I go to a class?
We're launching our first program this September. We are looking to fill a class of about 60 people. We still have open spaces. The cost is $27,000, and we're finding a lot of really excited interest, not only from individuals, but also increasingly from organizations in the area that have a demographic of employees that they feel, you know, we really want to help them raise their game.
How long is the program?
It's 9 months.
9 months, $27,000. Why not offer it online? Do you have to sit in class?
That is going to be offered after we lay the foundation for our first class. We definitely want to be able to reach much more broadly.
And are you seeing companies subsidizing their own employees to go learn?
Absolutely, absolutely. You know, the big book in human resources years ago was Built to Last, and I think today, because of the disruption and so many companies that are gaining these billion-dollar valuations so quickly, is companies need to build to thrive really quickly, and they don't always have the time to invest in developing their own people, and we want to be able to take the burden off office some of the enterprises to be able to help develop their talent.
And people aren't working at a company, let's say, for 10 or 20 years anymore. They're working at, you know, firms for 4 or 5 years, and then they're off to the next job. How has that affected what you're teaching?
Actually, Sal, it's even more significant than that. McKinsey just published a report that said millennials by the age of 40 will have 11 different jobs.
Wow. Wow.
So, and what we're seeing in the Bay Area right now, especially among technical workers, is 2.5 years staying in a company. So I think companies are challenged with how do we invest in our people, and individuals are challenged with how do I find a good place to learn the skills I need to put me in the front of the line in my organization.
All right, Steve, fascinating stuff. Well, we wish you all the best. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you. Thanks for coming in.
Sharing your story. Coming